Hello, this is CG Park. In this beginner-friendly blender series, I'll guide you through the full 3D creation of LABUBU, from the base shapes to the final fluffy finish. The tutorial is divided into three parts: modeling, texturing, and grooming. Let's begin with the modeling stage. First, using the image plane as a reference, I add a subdivision modifier to a cube and begin shaping the head. Next, I use inset faces to create the facial area. And I match the edges of the face to the front image plane, and once the front view looks correct, I switch to the side view to adjust the depth. And I create the nose in the same way. Since I don't need the backside, I select the faces and delete them, then fill the opening using grid fill. To make the shapes easier to read, I assign different materials with simple colors. And then I add more edges and adjust the fine details to match the image plane. And as the mesh flow started getting a bit uneven, I switched to sculpt mode to smooth out the bumps. And then for the eyes, I create the shape with a cylinder, then use it to cut into the face model. And after applying the boolean, I clean up the mesh. Next, I use the knife tool to create the shape of the mouth. The eyeballs are separate objects placed inside the head. Now I extrude the black part of the eye to give it more dimension and make it look richer. And I then adjust the face mesh so it fits snugly around the eyes. To keep things clear, I assign a separate material for the pupils as well. From here, I move on to sculpting the ears. Since the final silhouette will expand with fur, I model them while keeping that in mind. Just like the face, I match the front view to the image plane, then adjust the depth from the side view. I select the edges along the mouth line, duplicate them with Shift plus D, and convert the duplicated edges into a curve. In the curve properties, I add some bevel depth to make it tube-shaped. N. This will serve as a temporary mouth line. The final mouth line will be created with textures. Next, I move on to shaping the body, arms, and legs. Just like the head, I start from a low poly base and gradually form the shape by adding edges. Thank you. Anne and I apply bevels to sharpen the corners and add contrast to the silhouette. For the teeth, I first create a base shape. Then, using the mouth line curve I made earlier, I arranged the teeth with geometry nodes. And I start by adding instance on points, connect object info to the instance input, and choose the base tooth object. Next, I use resample curve to set the number of teeth to 9, and apply a line rotation so they properly follow the curve. When I checked the teeth in place, I noticed some issues with the base shape, so I fixed them. And I then add a rotation node in geometry nodes and rotate the instances along the x-axis. Since I want to edit the placed teeth individually, I convert them to a mesh in the final step. And I add realize instances at the top, then use visual geometry to mesh to convert them and adjust the teeth manually. Next is the hand modeling. LABUBU's hands are quite simple, so even with topology modeling, it isn't too difficult. As always, I begin with a low poly shape, then refine the details after adding subdivision. Lastly, I create the bump above the eyes. It looked simple at first, but it took more trial and error than I expected to achieve the right shape. I placed it as a separate object, applied a boolean to merge it, cleaned up the topology, and finished it with sculpting. Since I plan to add subdivision later, I used bevels to keep the shape from becoming too soft. After making small adjustments, the modeling is complete. Great job following along. It might feel a little difficult for beginners, and maybe a bit simple for intermediate artists. In the next video, I'll go over the texturing process. Please consider subscribing to the channel and stay tuned. See you in the next one.